सभी को मेरा प्रणाम, सभी को नमस्ते। मैं स्वागत करती हूँ आप सबका आज की शाम राग हंस ध्वनि के नाम। आज हमारे साथ जुड़ रहे हैं जया विद्यासागर जी, जो कैलिफोर्निया से हैं, और आज वो हमें राग हंस ध्वनि के बारे में पूरा अच्छे से परिचय देंगी और उसके बारे में हमें विस्तार रूप से बताएंगी। तो आज हम ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं जया विद्यासागर जी को। हेलो मैम।
हेलो, नमस्ते।
कैसे हैं आप?
आई एम गुड, आप कैसे हो?
मैं बहुत अच्छी हूँ, थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन मैम।
थैंक यू फॉर मूविंग द टाइम। आई नो ये काफी लेट है फॉर इंडिया, बट एनीथिंग एल्स माइट हैव बीन लाइक अ लिटिल टू अर्ली फॉर मी, सो थैंक यू फॉर
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग, नो वरीज मैम। क्योंकि वहाँ पे राइट नाउ इट माइट बी 8:30 AM, सो इट्स लाइक अ गुड टाइम फॉर प्रैक्टिसिंग इट। And you are having a musical morning and I'm having a musical evening.
Nice, I hope so.
Yeah. So, ma'am, can I have a little introduction about you? Ki, how did you started your musical journey and from basically you belong?
So, I belong to a South Indian family, but I grew up and I was born and raised in Mumbai in India. So my exposure for music started with Carnatic classical, actually. That's what I had started. Yeah, so I started very early in life, about 5 years of age or so, started learning music. And for the next few years, I trained in Carnatic classical under various gurus. And then I realized ki mujhe Hindustani was like drawing me for some reason. And there was, you know, that was something that was really appealing to me. And I started learning Hindustani classical, and I was really blessed with wonderful gurus in both styles of classical. In Hindustani especially, I feel very grateful to have learned from some amazing gurus like Srimati Vatsala Rao, who had taken some training from Mahubai Kordikarji from the Jaipur Atrauli Gharana. And of course, the greatest blessing of my life to have learned from Veena Sahasrabuddhiji. It's been a wonderful journey since then. And of course, now being here in the Bay Area in California, music still continues to be a very important part of life. And I have my own set of students, I have a music school, and music is like just going on. So it's just been music all life.
Wow, that's amazing.
Be a, you know, a full-time musician. I have a degree in finance. That's what I was thinking I'm going to do. But I think some things are just destined, right? So.
Wow, that's amazing. That's amazing. That's amazing to know. So, my first question for Raag Hans Dhwani, why did you choose this raag? Like, what is the reason behind choosing this raag today?
Okay, so two reasons. The first thing was, I remember when we started this conversation, I said, you know, my most favorite raag in the whole world is Yaman. But of course, I had you know, figured that it was already done. So some raags that make you feel very happy, you know, which leave you with a very good auspicious feeling, is something that really appeals to me a lot. And I thought, why not? Of course, every raag is beautiful, right? Every raag evokes a certain emotion. It is beautiful in its own way, but why not talk about a raag which is super auspicious and beautiful? And the second main reason being, Hamsadhwani is a raag that was derived from Carnatic classical, right? The roots of Hamsadhwani is there, and it was just borrowed, as we say, from Carnatic into Hindustani. And because I've had an exposure to Carnatic as well, of course, I don't claim to be a Carnatic musician, I don't sing that anymore, but I haven't. Exposure to it, so I thought, why not take a raag which is pretty strong in both styles, so I can kind of, you know, give you examples from both. So that was a reason for picking Hamsadhwani.
Wow, that's amazing! That's amazing! That's an amazing choice. And even I have figured out the facts about raag Hamsadhwani, that it was basically created by Ramaswamy Dikshitar ji, and the credit in taking this music, this raag from Carnatic to Indian classical music goes to Ustad Aman Ali Khan of Bhendi Bazaar Gharana. Yeah.
Correct. That's good. You've done your research beautifully. So a little bit of about Ramaswamy Dikshitar. For those who are not aware of much about Carnatic classical, there's the Trinity in Carnatic classical, John Kehte, the three people who really are like created so many beautiful kritis and created a foundation for Carnatic classical. One of them is Muthuswami Dikshitar, who has like a repertoire of kirtanams and kritis which are like amazing. Okay, his father was Ramaswamy Dikshitar. He was the one who created Raagam Sadhvani. So that's the connect. So it's pretty, yeah, just thought I would mention that. So.
Wonderful, wonderful. So I request you to start by teaching us or by providing us the details about the introduction, musical introduction of this Raag Hansdwani, both in the Carnatic style and in the Hindustani style. Because it is a pleasure to have you, like two in one.
Because you can get, of course, like I very put a disclaimer right at the beginning when I said, I'm not a Carnatic classical vocalist. I do not claim to be one, but yeah, I've had an exposure and training, so I definitely can give you some small examples.
Sure.
Basically, the rag is pretty much the same in both styles. It sounds exactly the same as the pentatonic scale, jo hum kehte hain, that is five swaras are there in Raagam Sadhvani. And the scale is exactly the same. Sari ga pa ni sa, sa ni pa ga re sa. So ma and dha, ye dono varjya hai missing in this rag. So aurav jati se jo kehte hain. इस ये राग की जो जाति है वो बिलावल थाट कही जमानी जाती है एंड सिमिलरली इन कर्नाटिक टू इट इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी अ जन्य ऑफ धीर शंकराभरणम दैट इज अ 29th मेलकर्ता जैसे थाट है हिंदुस्तानी में वी हैव The concept of Melakarta ragas in Hindus in Carnatic. So every
Yeah.
raga is derived from. So in that it is considered Shankarabharan, Dhira Shankarabharan, which is same like Bilawal. Okay, but again there are a few people who kind of consider that Hamsadhwani can belong to Kalyan Thaat as well. Similarly in Carnatic, the Kalyani. That
Okay.
yeah. There are various reasons why people consider that, but I think the standard practice is to consider it part of Bilawal. With all Shuddhaswaras. And the Vadi Samvadi, jo most important swara, second most important swara, same as
Percent.
Sa in Hamsadhvani, Sharja Pancham. Again, few people will consider Repa, some people will consider Garni, but Vo Karni se again, it will start sounding more part of Kalyan Thaat than Bilawal Thaat. So, agar hum
And
mante hain ki ye Bilawal ki hai, to we'll keep it assigned. Samay, jo हिंदुस्तानी में काफी इम्पोर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट है व्हेन यू प्रेजेंट अ राग सो द हमसध्वनि को रात का दूसरा प्रहर लिटिल आफ्टर सनसेट इज व्हेन इट इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी सम कर्नाटक में देर इज नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ दैट एज सच वेयर व्हेन इट इज सम देर इज नो टाइम साइकिल बट थिंक अबाउट हमसध्वनि इन कर्नाटक क्लासिकल एंड विच इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग इज Lot of my non-South Indian or non-Indian friends have asked me this question, and I thought, I should mention this. Hamsadhvani, because it is like something that evokes auspicious feeling or kind of a positivity and creates a very beautiful ambience, it is sung at the beginning of a concert in Carnatic. So beginning mein jaise hum Ganesh Vandana gaate, we sing something in praise of Ganesha. So there are a lot of kritis composed. On Ganapati in Hamsadhvani. You will find so many. In fact, one of the first most popular kritis that was composed by Muthuswami Dikshitar, that is the son of Ramaswami Dikshitar who created Hamsadhvani,
Yeah.
is Vatapi Ganapatim Bhaje. I think every Indian would kind of know it, right? Because it's so popular. And
Yeah.
jab ye raag ko liya tha Hindustani mein, when they kind of adapted, they kind of kept that base of Vatapi and that most popular bandish that. You hear Lagi Lagana Pati. So that one was, based on this one. So Ganesha is like, yeah. So that is something about himself. What else? Let me maybe just sing the, an Anubhav Yoga and kind of or just a
Okay.
feeling into it.
Yeah.
And then you will realize ki isme jo importance of the swara re hai. उस पे न्यास काफी ज्यादा होता है बिकॉज दैट इज वॉट ब्रिंग्स आउट अ ब्यूटी ऑफ दिस राग हम से Tell me if the Tanpura is too loud.
Tanpura is sounding good, but your voice is a bit low.
Getting drowned? So that's too loud, okay. So the tendency to keep coming back to re is very strong in this rag.
Okay.
So whenever we take part in, it's like, you know, so ye jo you will also understand why Spaniards re pe zyada karte hain, because I know it is too soon into the rag, but let me also just say Hamsadhwani is very similar sounding rag, or something which is very close to Hamsadhwani is rag Shankara. So Shankara has almost similar kind of swaras, but some, you know, phrases differentiate Shankara from Hamsadhwani. I'll come to that a little later. So coming back to re and not stopping on ga kind of, you know, differentiates those two. So the phrasing of kind of gives you, you know, that instant Hamsadhwani feeling. So
yeah,
that was a small introduction to Hamsadhwani. But what else would you like to know?
Yeah. So, can you please help us to know, like, what are the ways to show Vadi and Samvadi in focus? Like, what is the swaroop of the rag to show the Vadi and Samvadi in focus?
So, the like I said, the phrasing, right? So, kind of keeping on coming back to using pa as in yas and using re, and kind of having those kind of phrasings will kind of bring out that feeling of So, you know, those kind of phrasings bring out that sa and pa's interaction, and, you know,
yeah.
So if you end up spending too much time on ga and ni, then, I mean on ga, stopping on ga, then it starts to sound a lot like it belongs to Kalyan, and that ga and ni common makes it sound, yeah. Then you don't want phrases of Shuddha Kalyan and Shankara and those kind of things.
Yeah, of course, of course. So basically, one should not focus on Gandhar, but one focus on Rishabh.
Rishabh.
To show, because the thought belongs Bilawal, right?
Yeah.
Exactly. Great. So, guys, if you are having any kind of questions regarding the Swaroop, so please write down there. And we will start with the musical presentation as well, because she will be explaining more about the Swaroop section while performing as well.
I'm just going to take a chance and do this. I'll just give you a small phrase of what do you say, a small the mukhda jo kehte hain of the Pallavi, as we call of Vadapi, just to show how it was. That was one of the first. Because it's more popular, I'll show you probably one more. So just to show the Carnatic aspect of it, and then
okay, sure.
So I'm sure many of you guys would have heard this one, so I'm just going to
Vatap
This one is like one of the most popular Carnatic pieces of Hamsadhwani that you would hear. A lot of people do like Jugalbandis with it. You would have heard Think Kaushiki ji do it with, you know. Yeah, so this is one. And let me also, you know, give you like a small phrasing. Jaise Carnatic make वर्णम जो बोलते हैं विच इज लाइक यू नो आई स्टार्ट एट एन इंटरमीडिएटरी लेवल टू काइंड ऑफ गेट अ गुड ग्रास्प ऑन सिंगिंग अ स्ट्रक्चर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ अ सॉन्ग सो देर आर क्रिएटेड फ्रेजेज इन एज पार्ट ऑफ वर्णम वेर यू हैव लाइक द स्वरम्स और स्वरस विच आर सेट विद इन द सॉन्ग एंड सी हाउ ब्यूटिफुली दे हैव कंपोज दिस फॉर हमसदवानी आई जस्ट सिंग वन फ्रेज ऑफ दैट ओके नॉट
Sure.
I know this is more of a Hindustani, but the reason I'm bringing back a lot of this South Indian music is because the raag came from there, then it's easier to understand, you know, how beautiful it sounds in both styles.
And the actual swaroop of the raag.
Yeah, yeah. So this is, since it was created for, you know, based on raag Hamsadhwani, I think it will kind of bring it out much more. So I'll just sing only the swara part, not the lyrics, because it's not in Hindi or it's in the South Indian language.
Sure,
sure, sure. Gari gari sari, sari gari re ni gari ni sari, pani sari ga, pagari sari, ga pani re ga pani sari ga pani sari, ga pani re ga pani sa, re sari pani gari sari, pani sari ga. Within that wow. short, it kind of brings out so much about, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just thought it would be interesting for...
Of course. It is, because you know, most of the people who are watching this live session belongs to Indian classical, like northern part of classical music, and it is like really very interesting to learn more about Carnatic music, because the raag is basically origin from the Carnatic, so it's like more important as well to know the origin and the history and the actual swaroop of the raag from the origin, you know. So it's like a very good opportunity to for me as well to learn from you, because there are so many things, because I'm not so much close to Carnatic music, so like I am even learning so much from you, so thank you so much.
I'm glad, just a little bit of what I learned during my childhood which stayed with me at this, yeah. So
so ma'am, can we proceed by starting the, you know, compositions and performance for the classical one?
Okay, so let me do a very small, a quick piece on in Hindustani. Of course, there are a lot of beautiful pieces in Hindustani which are popularized by a whole lot of people. And I have learned some beautiful ones from my guru, Inatai. Some of it which requires a lot of riyaz and to be able to, you know, to present it. I could even sing a couple lines after I sing this bandish. But first, let me do one in Madhyalaya Teental. Again, pretty sweet, and you'll find this phrase of na ra ra na. So the way Vatapi is Vatapi. So a lot of those phrases. Ta ta nom ta nom ta da na bo la ta na. So that phrase keeps coming back, and it's very interesting to, you know, keep observing that. So I'm just going to sing one Madhyalaya Bandish, pretty quick. Just do a couple things in that, and yeah, sure. I'm going to. Please the tanpura a little bit. If it's too distracting, let me know. But I'll try and keep it, okay? It's just that morning and it's cold. My voice is not warmed up enough and, you know, ears are ringing. So I just need it louder. So
That's okay. That's okay. Please. Be comfortable the way you are.
It's pretty cold for spring even now, so yeah. Okay. Is it okay? The volume is okay?
Voice was like a bit disconnected because the sound was going like this. So please try to say.
Oh, it wasn't clear.
No. At some places it was not clear.
Was it breaking on and off?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Sorry about that. I'll probably try to.
That's okay. Yeah. So, apart from Shankara, what are the ragas that are like similar to Raghamsdhvani?
Let me just tell you about just Shankara first before I go, because Shankara is one of the closest, and I think that's the only one that kind of comes as close to Sadhwani compared to the others, which is popular because there are one or two maybe, but they're not as popular ragas. So I don't think there is something that is as close. But Shankara, yes, there is a chance of kind of getting into Shankara quite a bit. But what differentiates Shankara? Again, Bilawal Thatta, but you have this. Shankara's phrasing is very distinct, okay? One second, keep this low, so. Sa ga pa ni re sa ni pa ga pa re sa. Two places where you can clearly say there is a difference. Dha, use of dha in Shankara is very prominent. नी रे सा नी पा, तो टू मिटिगेट दैट इफ यू से ग प नी सा गा रे नी पा सा, दैट इज हमसे ध्वनि, बट
हेलो
नी रे सा नी पा एंड देन रे थोड़ा वीक है ये राग में, इट्स अ लिटिल इन शंकर. सो ग प रे सा, सो ग पे न्यास विल बी वेरी प्रोमिनेंट देयर. एंड यहाँ पे ग पा गे देन देर इज अ यू नो इवन इन द बंदिश यू कैन क्लियरली टेल अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ शंकर भंडार डोले मस्तक पर चंद शोभे. डजंट साउंड लाइक हमसध्वनि, राइट? व्हेन यू काइंड ऑफ हियर इट यू कैन टेल इट इज ये रे सजनी कामु सदन बिरमाए मोरे पिया ये रे सज. सो एंड व्हेन यू सिंग समथिंग ऑफ हमसध्वनि, निहरति रोहन गगनम श्वेत हंस आरूढ़ा, देन यू सी द यू नो सो दैट ध एंड द रे बिकमिंग लिटिल वीक इज व्हाट डिफरेंशिएट्स. Apart from that, not so popular rags, but I wouldn't even say they are like exactly the same kind of swaras, but kind of similar. You can say there is Hamsa Kalyan, but not very popular again. But Hamsa Kalyan is like a mixture of Hamsadhwani and Kalyan. So the first part is Sa Re Ga Pa Ni Sa, coming down. Sa Ni Ga Pa Ma Re Sa Ga. Apart from that, I think there's one more interesting rag. थोड़ा रेयर है बट आई डोंट इवन आई मीन आई हैव नॉट इवन लर्न बंदिश इज इन हमसे कल्याण. मलाश्री एक राग है जो काफी नॉट वेरी पॉपुलर बट वन वेरिएंट वो उसको ना हिंदुस्तानी में वी कांट इवन से दैट इट इज काइंड ऑफ पार्ट ऑफ इट बिकॉज जैसे हिंदुस्तानी में राग के जो व्हाट डू यू से डिसिप दो व्हाट व्हाट इज द टर्म आई एम नॉट गेटिंग इट यू हैव रूल्स राइट फॉर राग दैट मिनिमम 5 स्वरस. So this rag has only 4 swaras, but different variants of it. Yeah. So I said that has just 4 swaras. It's not considered like a rag rag. It won't come under the typical rules because it just takes about 4. That's one variant of it which kind of sounds, but there's no rishab in that rag. Sa sa ga pa ni sa ni pa ga sa, with the shade of Tivramadhyam. But apart from that, I think Shankara is the only one that comes closest to it.
And the silent flautist is saying there has been rag Shankhadhwani.
Okay, I'm not too familiar with that drug, but probably heard it. Maybe he should. Where is that?
I have noted down that as well. I'll check this out. Shankhadhwani.
Yeah, because I'm sure there would be a bunch of it, but when you look at the popular ones, I guess these are the
100%.
just comes into, you know, I mean, which are popularly sung, right? And yeah, which most people recognize. And yeah,
Hansa Kalyan is a Carnatic rag, right?
I think it's there in Hindustani too. I'm not like, again, I'm not too familiar. It's not very popular, but I've just heard about it from my gurus when they would just kind of mention it briefly. But Hamsa Kalyani, yeah, is also there in Carnatic. But again, I'm not sure if it is too popular in terms of having too many kritis or many people singing. But there'll be a lot of variants where there'll be rags, combination rags. But if you look at rags which use a similar kind of swaras, then I think it is just like.
So The silent flautist is telling us the hamsdhvani raga with komal nishad
Okay.
is shankdhvani.
Nice. Interesting to know. Good to know that.
He's an amazing flautist and he has started a challenge as well of 365 days and 365 ragas. So,
Wonderful.
Yeah. So he's one of the amazing flautists. So he's having a bunch of knowledge about the ragas.
Oh, beautiful. Very nice. That's good to know. Yeah. Always nice to know newer things, right? So it's good to know.
So ma'am, can you tell us more about the swarup of Shankara? A bit more about Shankara.
Yeah, it is pretty much what I, because that's the phrasing of it. So I don't think, I mean, no, just adding that. So even listening to those Jai Shiva Shankar Jai Ganga Karuna Kar Karta Hare Hare Jai Shiva Shankar, it completely just brings out the phrasing of Shankara. I might just need to plug in my phone into the charger. So
yeah, for sure, for sure.
Yeah.
Please.
And yeah. Maybe a few more examples of non like classical, semi-classical, or lot of movie songs that you know, Hamsadhwani has inspired, both in south as well as in north. I think those will give a better will also give a brief what do you say, kind of idea about this rag, because I remember we had talked about bhajan, and right,
yeah,
had an example. What lalishk is a Shankara? No, lalishk is not Shankara. Lalishk is a blend of Yaman and a little bit of Hamsadhwani in between, and some of the interlude also has a bit of Nand in Lalishk, but it's more of Yaman, I think. Sanjay Bansali sticks to a lot of Yamans.
100%.
No, there was a question there, I thought, okay. So there is this very popular bhajan by Hridayanath Mangeshkar ji, who is composed, I think Lata ji has sung it, I forget the name of the album, Chal. Meera Bhajans ki jo wo jo ye hai song hai, kya hai, karma ki gati nyari santo, I don't know.
Yeah, it's a very famous bhajan.
Very famous one, right? So that kind of gives a good flavor of
karma ki gati nyari santo badi badi nayan diye mere gan ko bala bala phire te uhari santo karma ki gati nyari santo.
Then you would have heard this
jai to se nahi bolun kahiya.
Salil Chaudhary's ji's composition from the film Parivar, Manade and Manari ji and Lata ji would have sung it.
Lata ji, yes. Yeah.
Very similar phrasing, right? If you hear the most popular composition of Vatapi, and
jai to se Vatapi, right? Almost, I guess almost each composition of Hamsadhwani is having this phrase.
Correct. So then it's, but that's the beauty also, it kind of helps you to identify the rag instantly also, right?
Yeah.
Some distinct compositions that I have heard, which of course movie songs, it's very hard to kind of stay within the rag completely. Apart from if you are really composing it for it, like this Jato Se Nahi is set to Hamsadhwani, stays there. South mein there are a lot of songs too, which are based on Raga Hamsadhwani. Rehman ji has composed a very beautiful one, you know, which was for World Peace, kind of a peace-based song for a movie, which was based on that Sri Lankan refugees and those kind, that, you know, the unrest that happened there. So that song is also based on Hamsidhwani. I don't know, a lot of South Indians would have definitely heard that. வெள்ளை பூக்கள் உலகம் எங்கும் மலரவே Something like that. So beautiful, you know, you would have done such a beautiful job on that. So that was based, and there is one very popular song too by Ilaiyaraaja sir. I'm not sure how many would have heard it, but Sri Rangarangan Padam Vandanam Seyyadi Sri Devi Ranganathan Naamam Santhakam Solladi இன்பம் பொங்கும் தெங்கங்கள் நீராடி தென்றல் போல நீயாடே மஞ்சள் குங்குமம் மங்கை நீ சூடி தெய்வ பாசுரம் பாடடி ஸ்ரீரங்கநாதன் பாதம் வந்தனம் செய்யடி. So beautiful, right? So
Wow.
these are of the songs that kind of keep coming to my mind for you.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Think the you know easier way is to kind of understand a rag or to kind of get into the depth of the rag if you are not a classical musician is to actually start with the popular film songs that
100%, 100%. And even many people search on YouTube as well ki which songs are available in this rag or which songs are bhajan or ghazals are in which rag. So, because it really makes easier to understand and to identify the rag. Because जब किसी को सुनने में आदत पड़ जाती है तो वो पहचान एक बनने लगती है. They are easily able to understand the स्वरूप of the rag through songs.
जी इज हियर राइट. हेलो राजेश जी. राजेश वैद्य जी इज वन ऑफ दी प्रोमिनेंट लाइक लीडिंग वीणा प्लेयर्स इन साउथ. ही इज लाइक दैट्स इट वीणा
हम
एंड
लोग
राजेश वैद्य जी इज लाइक नमस्ते राजेश जी. सो नाइस टू सी यू.
I'm so glad. I'm so glad. I'm so honored, actually. Oh my God.
You should listen to some of the music is
Yeah,
he's like
I used to listen. I used to, for a time, I was like very surprised. Oh my God, is he the only one that I listen him on YouTube? So it's like a very exciting moment for me right now. Oh my God. I had been listening to him since past 5 years.
Wow, that's nice, amazing. How did you find it? What was the song or what was the music that?
Used to play sitar, so
Oh, you play sitar.
well, yeah. So when I used to find some ragas and songs in sitar, so he was also there, like the suggested videos. But once I listened to him, and I was like addicted to him, and back to back, I kept hearing his compositions and like 1 minute videos he make for Instagram. Oh my God, they're awesome, awesome. Yeah, because I'm not that much familiar to Carnatic music, so I just keep the melody with myself, but forget the lyrics.
Oh, yeah. It's also hard to kind of language, right? It's not a language you're familiar with, so it's kind of hard to relate to it. Yeah, but it's great that listening to South Indian songs too.
Because all the mantras and stotram, the bhajan and all the spiritual divinity that has origin is from South India only, I guess. Because in North India there are very kind of very less mantras that are being chanted. But in South India, the culture, the divinity, and the tradition has been maintained till date. Yeah, so that's the best part. Because when we read about the history of music, so the music starts from Dhruva Geet. So what was Dhruva Geet? Dhruv means the truth, and the Geet means the song of the truth. And what is the truth? So God is the only truth that is available. So that is आई गेस सबसे बड़ी बात, ज्यादा बड़ी बात है कि साउथ इंडिया के लोग आज भी उस चीज को अपने मन में रखकर चल रहे हैं और अपने बच्चों को भी वही चीज वो सिखा रहे हैं और उन सबको, मतलब मैं देखती हूँ कि जितने भी मेरे साउथ इंडियंस लोगों से कनेक्शन होता है, सो दे स्टार्ट विद देयर डे विद द प्रेयर्स, बट
या
दिखता है अब ऐसा बहुत कम दिखता है. सो आई यूज टू लिसन कुलदीप एम पाई जी, ही इज वन ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल आर्टिस्ट. या सो आई लिसन टू वेरियस भजन्स एंड स्त्रोत्रस ही यूज टू गिव बाय हिज इनिशिएटिव. सो आई जस्ट आई एम इन लव विद साउथ इंडियन मंत्र चैंटिंग एंड आई इवन यूज टू डू द मंत्र चैंटिंग एज वेल. आई हैव ऑल्सो इनिशिएटेड माई श्रीमद भगवद गीता रेसिटेशन सीरीज ऑन यूट्यूब. सो आई हैव कंप्लीटेड लाइक 9 chapters
Oh,
एंड
wonderful. That's
या
really
फ्रॉम वेंसडे आई विल बी स्टार्टिंग द 10th chapter.
very nice, beautiful. Good to know because I think that is also one genre that is very close to my heart. Though I sing a whole lot of things, other things. But if you look at my YouTube channel too, I think the most prominent thing that I keep doing is mantras and shlokas and those kind of, because that's something that I think also resonates with me as a musician. And I think it's, when you have this gift of music, you should kind of use it in a way that is makes you feel a little closer to, right?
अपार्ट फ्रॉम द जॉनर, व्हेन वी सी द हिस्ट्री, तो सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि संगीत का मतलब ही यही था कि आप ईश्वर से कनेक्ट हो. इफ यू आर नॉट कनेक्टिंग टू गॉड, यू कैन नॉट कनेक्ट विद योर सेल्फ एंड यू कैन नॉट कनेक्ट विद एनी वन एल्स. इट्स ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्रेस ऑफ गॉड कि आपके संगीत से मैं कनेक्ट हो पा रही हूँ. अगर वो ईश्वर
That's
की
true.
कृपा ना हो तो आप कुछ भी गाएं तो मैं कनेक्ट नहीं हो सकती उससे.
That is very true. Correct. Perfect.
सो
Perfectly said. Beautiful.
जो भी म्यूजिशियंस हैं उनको अपने ईश्वर को तो बिल्कुल नहीं भूलना चाहिए. उनको याद करते हुए ही आप जो करें वो करें. वो जो संगीत है वो ईश्वर का प्रसाद है.
Definitely.
इसीलिए इसको सबसे पहली ललित कला, सबसे पहला जो 62 कलाएं जो थी श्री कृष्ण भगवान के साथ, उसमें सबसे पहली कला संगीत था. तो इसीलिए वो हाथ में बांसुरी लिए हुए थे. वो छोटी बात नहीं होती.
Of course, that is true. Very, very, very well said. Very true.
Thank you. That's why even I used to recite different mantras. I try to learn बहुत सारे mantras like South Indian language में हैं जो समझ नहीं आते, but I try to understand the meaning, like to find the English translation of it and to understand and to chant it, because all of the in total it is all going to God.
Anything that you chant, right, with a true feeling. And I mean, a lot of Sanskrit verses, I'm sure many of us do not really understand, but I think it's true, yeah. But knowingly chanting is beautiful, but without knowing chanting is still got its merits, right? It's still chanting, so.
100%. So yes, so because we have a really good conversation on the mantra, so I personally want you to present a beautiful bhajan or any mantra like presentation right now in Raghans Dhwani. We are coming back.
Yeah, I'm thinking whether I know some. I've done something in. Oh yeah, actually, in Hamsadhwani. You want it in Hamsadhwani only?
Yeah, enhanced money only.
Let me do one thing. Give me a quick minute. Let me pull up the lyrics. Actually, I have composed something in Hamsadhwani, which is there on my YouTube too. I had done something with. Again, Ganesha is the most favorite god when it comes to Hamsadhwani. Let me do a little bit of. I've done the Ganesha Pancharatnam in Hamsadhwani. I'm just going to maybe as much as I can remember now. Okay. We started with Ganesha, right? I think we should end with. मुदाकरात्मोदकं सदा विमुक्तिसाधकं कलाधरावतंसकं विलासिलोकरक्षकम् अनायकैकनायकं विनाशिते भदैत्यकं नताशुभाशुनाशकं नमामि तं विनायकं नमामि तं you ask me to sing more, I have to look at the lyrics and I will make mistakes which I'm not
जय
used
गणेश जय गणेश जय गणेश पाहि माम. आई लव दिस मंत्र
to. This rag or the bhajan or the whole feeling
मंत्र,
of.
दिस चैंटिंग. आई लव दिस राग इज वेल एंड द मंत्र इज वेल.
Of course. Yeah.
So I think you have prepared one bhajan as well in this Hamsdhwani raga.
Oh, I did. I just sang the Karma Ki Gati Nyari, but
Yeah.
yeah, that was the
But
one. Yeah. That was the one. Yeah. But yeah, if you want to sing something, I could. You want me to sing that again? No, right?
no. Something
Yeah.
else.
Let me end with
आई गिरी नंदिनी.
He's like way off from Hamsadhwani. The way I sing Aigiri Nandini is in Bairagi Bhairav. You don't want to shift from Hamsadhwani into it.
Of course.
Let me just check. Okay, Hardik ji, Aigiri Nandini, I will sing specially in Bairagi Bhairav next time when probably I do some session with Paridhi ji in Bairagi Bhairav. Okay?
Sure.
Not.
Bairagi Bhairav is one of my favorite ragas. I love Bairagi Bhairav. It's like so
Beautiful.
connecting with my heart. Oh my God, I love it. I have composed one of the Strotra Rudrashtakam in Bairagi Bhairav. So
Oh,
I'll
nice.
be like, yeah, I'm posting it later.
Yeah, whole feeling is so beautiful of it. It's an apt one for right for that. Yeah.
Divine, very divine.
Okay, let me leave you with. It's not a bhajan, but it's a kriti, but it's on Ganesh, and it's composer Muthiah Bhagwate ji, and again on Ganesha. So let me leave you with that one. So I'm giving so much. What do you say? As much as I keep saying, oh, I only sing Hindustani, I love Hindustani, Carnatic didn't, but the roots are there. And I feel like the tribute to Carnatic is like, coming out through this rag. So I'm just going to end with a small with that, yeah? गणपते नमो गणपते नमो नमो शंकरी कन्हैया नमो नमो गमो गणपते नमो नमो शंकरी कन्हैया नमो नमो अंकुश धर मंगल अंकुश धर अंकुश धर This is amazing. Sanskrit is so close to my heart and the mantras are so close to my heart. This genre is actually so close to my heart, and I'm really thankful to you for this beautiful session, because possibly this is one of my favorite sessions for today. Till Thank
now, this is like my favorite session.
you. Thank you. I'm so glad. And I must tell you, it was such a pleasure talking to you. I mean, right from the beginning, there's something about your whole the persona, which is so graceful, so calming, very beautiful. And I was like, oh, I must do this. And so I kept thinking back and forth, which rag. Then I realized it's going to be morning. So I was like, should I do something which is a morning rag? But then I realized most of, your audience is in India, and something evening might be better. But of course, it's neither there nor here. But I just took a chance with this. I'm so glad that you were receptive to the fact that Carnatic is not, something that is, I know you meant it to be a pure Hindustani session, but I just couldn't resist the temptation to kind of keep delving into Carnatic to bring a few nuances. So I'm so glad that
Because Hamsdhwani is now very popular in Hindustani classical music, so it was like really easy to accept that rag. And even I had been singing this rag since I guess 9 years or such. I learned this rag in 2007.
Wow. So you learned it on the or as a vocal
In the vocal one.
vocal. Okay,
Yeah.
nice.
So
You should
I'm connected to this rag since the last 13 years. So when I was a very young kid, and my Kul Guruji taught me a bhajan in this raga, Mohe Braj Bisrat Nahi Udho, Hans Sutta Ki Sundar Ka Meri Aru Kunchan Ki Dahi. That was the bhajan. So I was like, I guess 12 or 13 years old when I learned this. So this rag is like, it was on the first page of my new notebook. So this was like, whenever I used to practice, I open the first page and start singing that bhajan. So
Nice.
that is why I was so glad to accept this rag, and I was like, oh my God, I'm going to live my childhood days back with this rag.
So glad. Maybe you should sing a few lines of your favorite bhajan, and then before you come
Yeah,
to a
sure. Let me sing this one only. मोहे ब्रज बिसरत नाही उधो मोहे ब्रज बिसरत नाही उधो हंस सुता की सुंदर कमरी अरु कुंजन की जाहे जाहे मोहे ब्रज बिसरत नाही. I have been talking since day, so it's like
It's perfect.
tired voice.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? With every vocalist, it's kind of hard to, yeah, the voice needs to be in a pristine condition to start singing. You get tired, and then, yeah, it's kind of hard. But beautiful,
Definitely.
so nice. You've got such a sweet voice. So glad.
Thank you so much.
Glad to add this, such a great
Before
start to.
what? Kindly pardon.
And I said, such a great start to my Sunday morning. So I'm so glad.
Oh, wow. Such a great end to my Sunday evening. Wow.
Nice.
This was such a beautiful session. Thank you so much. I'm giving you virtual hugs. Yeah,
Thank you. Thanks to everybody who watched it too. Yeah, I know it's a little late in India, and I know it's a little Sunday morning people sleep in the States, but I'm so glad
California.
you joined.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for joining in.
Oh,
We'll
thank
be
you.
definitely having more sessions like this. Like, I'm maybe in Bairagi only. Oh my God, thank you so much for joining in. I cannot express my happiness actually. I'm so glad. I'm so glad. Thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you. And apologies for, the small, what is not the small, I mean, the fact that some of it wasn't heard enough. I know the whole point of a music session is to be, for the music to be heard by everyone. But it's, I just want to tell people that there's a lot of limitations we have in Instagram Live. So we work with all that. So it's kind of hard for us also to predict. It's not that we don't want our voice to be heard. Of course, we want our voice to be heard. That's the whole point. Right, but hopefully we'll try and get something done better. But at least I'm glad it didn't glitch and stuff. The internet was pretty good, and that was good.
Yeah.
But we also learn, right? We learn how to keep it better. Yeah, hopefully next time will be a better time.
Music is like a forever subject. No one can be a teacher in this. Everyone is a student. जब तक सब सीखते रहेंगे तब तक आगे बढ़ते रहेंगे. जहां कोई गुरु बन के बैठ गया तो वहां उसका सीखना बंद हो जाएगा.
I know, correct. All right.
100%. यहाँ पे हमारे साथ जो जुड़े, जितने भी लोग जुड़े, आप लोगों का सबका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, तहे दिल से शुक्रिया आपके, आप हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए। अपना प्यार ऐसे ही हम पर बनाए रखिएगा, हमसे जुड़े रहिएगा। आगे का लाइव, अगले लाइव सेशन में हम आपसे मिलेंगे एक नए आर्टिस्ट के साथ। तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, सबको नमस्ते, बाय बाय।
बाय।